वॉइस इज क्लियर एंड आई एम ऑडिबल? ओके
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल।
फाइन, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द न्यू टॉपिक व्हिच इज डीएनएस हैकिंग एंड द काउंटर मेजर्स। सो फॉर दिस आई जस्ट वांट टू शो अ पीडीएफ एंड विल जस्ट टेक अ ब्रीफ ऑफ व्हाट इज डीएनएस एंड why it is so important for ethical hacking and for hacking purposes. My screen is visible. I thought it's visible. So let's start with the DNS. This time the topic is of DNS hacking and the countermeasures of the DNS. And we all know, because you are the faculty and you must aware about the DNS thing. DNS is a domain name system, and it is actually used to resolve the domain name over the internet. So we are using over the application layer, we are using this DNS for the resolve the domain name through the IP. So when from IP, so whenever we are putting any domain name like www.google.com, then it resolves with the IP, which is actually known by the network. The IPs are known by the network, and the domain name by the domain name come into the picture, because we don't have memorized each and every IP of any of the website, because lots of websites are there. So it is important as perspective of ethical hacker. It is a very important thing, because for this DNS, actually we enumerate several things, and for me it is a, because it is a basic step of ethical hacking. As I told you earlier in the last session, that information gathering is the foremost or important part of for an ethical hacker. You are gathering more and more and more in information, and you are about to near for an attack or for penetrate into a particular system. Because for penetration testing thing, it is only a one or two step, or you are having your script with you, or you are having a good tool with you, then you penetrate into the particular infrastructure and application. But if you not doing your homework, like information gathering, then it is very typical or hard to penetrate into the infrastructure, because you don't have any information related to your target. So I'm giving you a simple example. Like if someone is a thief and who want to stole something or steal something from a particular house, then he or she is doing a reconnaissance. It is called recce. When I'm using a layman word, it is a recce. It is a, because he or she will do the recce or reconnaissance, and he or she will gather the information about a particular house, or about a particular shop, or about a particular target, that how many members are there, what is their sleeping time, who else, what age group is there in the particular house, means how many of above 60, how many of below 60, how many of childs. So these things are, they are actually want to gather the information, and they are also gathering the information through some other people. As I told you earlier, that we are doing a passive reconnaissance. Like if someone is the maid on that particular house, then they are calling to maid, they give some bribe to the maid, and gather the information. When there no one in the house, where all the entrance of the house, where is the exit from the house, where is the emergency exit. So they gather each and every information, and on a very good fine day or fine night, they do penetrate into the particular house, or they steal or stole the goods and money and anything they want. So information gathering is a foremost or a very important part to penetrate or attack on a particular target. So in this information gathering, there is means, if I'm going for the information gathering, my first task is to find out the IP address of a particular target. What is the IP address? Because I am floating my attack. I am doing my attack on the if I am having the IP address of a particular target. So as you've seen on my screen, there is a DNS enumeration. So the penetration testing is a method of evaluating the security of a computer system. So it is a summarize of what I am talking to you. So the first step of penetration testing is, or more accurately called information security testing, is information gathering. Information gathering is a part of preparatory pre-attack phase and involves accumulating data regarding a target environment and architecture, usually for the purpose of finding ways to intrude into the environment. Information can gathering can reveal system vulnerabilities and identify the ease with which they can be exploited. As I told you that because information gathering is the foremost and important part. So we know we are not moving or digging into a more theory. We are doing the hands-on things. So before that, I'm just clearing you some simple concept regarding to the DNS. So using the combination of tool and techniques, we actually know the specific domain names, network blocks, subnets, routers, and individual IP addresses. So what DNS actually, what is the DNS enumeration process and what DNS is consist of? So DNS enumeration is the process of locating all the DNS server and their corresponding records for an organization. So for every organization, there is a DNS server. They are having their different IPs associated with them. Like they are having the name servers, they are having the mail exchange servers. So they are having each and every IP of those things. And someone from the internet community prior to access that particular domain name, then they the domain name servers are the whole sole entity or the server. They are responding for their queries and convert that domain name into the IP. So the DNS enumeration, we actually did give the name information gathering as an enumeration. So we enumerate the DNS with different informations. So the DNS enumeration is the process of locating all the DNS servers and their corresponding records for an organization. A company may have both internal and external DNS servers that can yield information such as usernames, computer names, IP address of the potential target systems. So there are a lot of tools that can be used to gain information performing DNS enumeration. So we'll take up those tools also. So what DNS records are consist of? So the following things are there. A, the maps the host name to the IP address. The A record is denotes the IP address of the host. Then SOA is start of authority. So DNS server responsible for the domain information. Who is the authority? Then canonical names, their name, their aliases, different names are there. Their MX mail identify the mail server for the domain. SRV identify the services such as directory services, PTR, MIPS, IP address to host names. That is reverse lookup, like IP address to host and host to IP address. So A is for host to IP address and PTR is for a reverse lookup. And their name servers, they are different name servers for primary, secondary, and more. So there is a zone transfer in the DNS also. Then if someone change, if the some information change in the primary, then it is also reflected into the secondary servers. So the secondary server is the first entity who respond. Then if secondary server doesn't have any information, then it goes to the primary server. If there are any updation in the primary server, they are reflected in the secondary server. And this particular process is called zone transfer. Means the primary is sending a replica to the secondary, and they are and the secondary is updated itself with the primary whatever the updation given by the primary servers. So we also gather the name servers. So for this thing, for enumerate thing, then we will go to the Kali Linux. Just show you window.
Yes, sir.
Just a second. I just present my window. So here is the Kali Linux, and just digging out what all information we are actually gathered to the DNS enumeration. So I'll just start with a new window. Let's start with the simple command, which is called nslookup. It is visible to everyone. Mumta ma'am, please confirm.
Yes, sir, visible.
Fine, okay. Then this is a tool which is called nslookup, and this is a basic tool run both in Linux as well as the Windows server. So with this help of this tool, we just digging out some information which is very important for us. So we just dig out some information. Like I just write DNS, then type is equal to MX. Or either write nslookup -1 query is equal to MX, and write any of the domain name. I'll just write www.google.com. So it's a non-authoritative answer. The mail address is dns.admin.google.com, and the origin is ns1.google.com. Now we'll look into another one. I just write hack this site .org. This is the mail address. Now I'm just trying nslookup -- query.
Vipin sir.
Yes.
थोड़ा सा फ़ॉन्ट साइज़ आप इंक्रीज कर सकते हैं?
Font size. Not visible?
Yes, sir.
Then write www.google.com. So it's not giving any answer. Because some of the server are not replying, so it gives a simple information with us. Then NS1, there is a name server google.com, and there is a mail address dns.admin.google.com. So we move forward, and we just trying a tool which is called fears. I just write fears. ps.dns /dns and write www.microsoft.com. Years. So it is like that. I'm writing fiercedns.google.com. So what actually we want to check that all the IP address associated with the DNS. Okay. And the next thing, what is the mail addresses? What is the mail server exchange IP? The foremost and the important thing we want to gather through the DNS enumeration is the subdomains. What all subdomains are associated with the google.com. Okay. So if I'm writing fiercedns.google.com, you also want to write in your Kyle Linux machine. It is an open source tool, Fierce, F-I-E-R-C-E, and it is pre-installed in the Kyle Linux. So if I'm writing fiercedns.google.com, then it check with the first, it is actually told us what DNS servers of the google.com across the internet. So there are four name servers, NS1234. google.com. Then they are trying for zone transfer, but it's not allowed because there are firewalls and there are so many security equipments in between of the zone transfer. So they are not supposed to, we are not supposed to do the zone transfers. Then in the third step, what the peers did, it is doing the brute force. It is having their own word list and it is starting the brute forcing, and through brute force it wants to try the to enumerate the different subdomains. So sometimes when I'm when we are going for the ethical hacking or bug bounty things, then the subdomains are helps us a lot, because sometimes in many of the websites they are actually doing did a very good security configuration on their main websites, but sometimes there are some subdomains which is not accurately secure. So because of those subdomains, we just want to penetrate into a particular domain name. So sometimes Asia, like as you've seen here, just see, there are, these are the subdomains of Google. We only know that google.com is only the domain, but with that domain, they are associated many of the subdomains like about.google.com, academic accounts, admin, ADS, AI, alerts. So there are so many subdomains which are associated with the Google. And as an ethical hacker or bug bounty or a security researcher, we just want to penetrate in those subdomains, because as we know that the main website is fully secured. If we want to try anything onto that, we just waste our time. So for ethical hacking purpose or for a penetration testing purpose, we just want to know that what all the subdomains are associated with the particular domain. So this fears help us to find out the subdomains which is associated with the google.com. Likewise, there is I'm using a testing website, hackthissite.org. Then it is also gives me the mail exchange server IPs. It is also gives me the hackthissite.org name servers IPs. Then it is also provide me the information of what all subdomains and their corresponding IPs for this hackthissite.org. So it is easy for as an ethical hacker to gather the information of domain and enumerate each and everything, whatever the tools provide us. We enumerate each and every single piece of the information regarding the domain name, and this help us to further penetrate into the system. So let's suppose if we don't find any way through google.com and we have a way, we find some vulnerabilities in their subdomains, then we have to have penetrated into the system, and we not just penetrated into the system, we just means it's just for a purpose. It's not a purpose of hacking. We just want to know the vulnerability, and we reported that vulnerability to Google or to any of the websites. They are having their own programs, research programs, security research programs, and they are giving you some money or either giving you the Hall of Fame. So as an hacker or security researcher, our first task to find out the subdomains associated with the particular target. So now comes to another topic. This is the tool. There are so many tools, as I just show you that all other tools, Fears and NSLookup. There are another tools. Like There are another tools. Fierce is there. There is a DNS Enum. It is also a tool. It is working same like Fierce and NS Lookup did. Then there is a another there is a host command in the Pi Linux, and there is a dig command. So all the commands are doing the same thing. Means all the tools are doing the same thing. So we just hands on those particular commands, and I'm just list out the name of these commands. NS lookup is a basic command. It is running on the both the operating systems like a Windows and Linux. Then there is a dig command, host command, DNS enum, and fierce. These four tools are help you out about some information like just dig didn't like DNS enum didn't provide us the subdomain. Then we just try to go to the fierce. If fierce is not provided about the subdomain, then we are just going to the dig. So these commands are help us to find out to enumerate the domain names. So for domain names, as I told you that we collect some of the information like their a name, like their IP addresses. This means our whole sole purpose of enumerate a DNS is just to find out what all the subdomains are present of a particular target. First thing, second information we want to gather their a name and their reverse lookup IP, means IP to host and host DNS and DNS to IP. Their mail exchange server IPs and their name servers IP. So sometimes these are the IPs of the server. Then further, what we want to enumerate, we enumerate actually that what on what server they are running, like their server, they are running on the Windows server or they are running on the Linux server. And we just after that, we just want to know that what services are running on those servers. So because the services running on that servers or what operating systems they are running on, so using those versions, we find out the vulnerabilities if they are having. If they are not patch their servers properly, then we find out that some vulnerabilities like that also, and we just go to the internet trying for find some payloads or script to further exploit that particular server. So if we are having the IPs and if we are having the names of that particular servers of which is related to a particular domain, then we actually solve the 50% of the exercise. Because we are having the address where we want to penetrate. We are having the target address. If I am just saying you that there is a target which is located at a particular location of India. But if you don't know what is the exact address, what is the exact location, so you didn't do anything. You can't do anything. So for that purpose, we have to have use some tools like that. So I have shared that document with the Mamta ma'am, so you'll take up that document from there. Then those tools are help us to find out the information regarding the DNS. Now we come to the next topic and just do some hands-on. So how, if I am having let's suppose there is a scenario, I am having let's suppose I am having the DNS file of a particular server, and if I want, or I am having privilege of a particular machine, so I'm changing the host file or the DNS file of a machine and redirect all the traffic to my system. So how can it possible? And this thing is called DNS poisoning. We poison the DNS names, DNS file of a particular machine, and we just redirect each and every request. Let's suppose if someone want on a particular machine, someone wants to redirect to google.com. Then he or she types google.com in their browser and redirect to the attacker website. Then how it is possible? It is possible because of DNS poisoning. So we just move to the another exercise. Just going there and just present my machine. So here is my Kali Linux machine. So
okay.
जस्ट वांट टू नो द आईपी एड्रेस. This is a sample DNS file. I'll just show you one second. Okay, this is the Kali Linux machine, right? So we are having two machines. There is a scenario which is there is a this is the Kali Linux machine, and I'm having another machine with me, which is Windows 7. So Windows 7 is the attacker machine, and the Kali Linux machine is the just open one another machine, Windows 10. So what is actually the whole sole purpose? I just So what is the whole sole scenario? The scenario is like let's suppose there is a machine A, which is the victim machine. Either it is Kali Linux, or Windows 10. Okay, B is the attacker machine, and what we want to do, we are doing DNS poisoning. If I'm giving a simple example, there is a host file in the means /etc/host. There is a host file /etc/host, host or host file in Windows and Linux both, and Linux. There is a file which is called etter.dns file in the Linux, Kali Linux machine. These are the DNS files in the Windows machine as well as the Linux machine. So if we want to run any particular domain name with their IP, we do, let's suppose I'm doing some task on the VPN, and I'm not connected to the internet. So I just put an entry in the etc host file in Windows or Linux to want to access that particular machine or particular web application. So what we do, we are doing DNS poisoning with the help of ARP spoofing and sniffing. Okay, but what attacker does, they are the another method why we are doing DNS poisoning. How it is possible? If we are having privilege of the server, is means I'm the attacker. I'm just putting the payload and I'm having the privilege of the server. Then I want to change the host file. This is the second scenario. But if I don't have the that particular machine privilege, but I'm in the same network, this particular DNS poisoning is only be does in the same network. If the attacker in the same network. This exercise second scenario, when the privilege of the server, I want to change the host, when you are not in the same network, you are doing remotely. It is remotely. So for remote, we have to have a privilege of that particular server. So we are doing the thing remotely. We are not in the same network. But if we are in the same network, then with the help of ARP spoofing and sniffing, then we does the particular exercise. So this is also the scenario. So I am having the victim Kali Linux or Windows, and the attacker machine, which is my Windows 7 machine. Windows 7, and I am here using canonable as a tool. And for second exercise, we are doing two exercises. I am using Attercap, the sniffer. Both are the sniffing. Both tools are used for sniffing and spoofing. So we are using canonable and Attercap. So now let's move to the exercise. So I'll just share my screen. This is the Windows 7. So I just start Windows 7. So I'm already installed Canonable. You also installed or download the Canonable from the website oxid.it. So it's not an open source. It's having a limited functionality with us. So there is the tool, which is Canonable tool. So for what is the first step? First step is actually we are start with the starting that particular tool, and we just go, there is a tab sniffer. So I just start sniffer. I just remove all the entries. I just click on the sniffer, and there is a icon over there. This is the APR icon. I just start that APR icon, go to the plus, and scan all the IPs associated in the particular network. So I just want to scan all the IPs, whatever the IPs are from, because it is a subnet of 192.168.188.1. So all the IPs are in the same network. So if you are doing that particular practical on a VM machine, then put all the machines on the net, or either host only, but not host only, because host only is not providing you the internet functionality. You just put all the adapter in the net, means all the devices are on the net, so they are having the same IPs. And first of all, just check that all are ping each other. Okay, so you just first confirm that all the IPs are ping each other, then this particular practical is successfully done. Then I'll explain you. I just close this. You install or you download Canonable, because it's an exe file. It is not possible to share with you people. So I just go start Canonable. यस जस्ट व्हेन इट स्टार्टेड देन गो टू द स्निफर फॉर एक्टिवेट द स्निफर यू जस्ट क्लिक ऑन टू दी दिस पर्टिकुलर आइकन एपीआर इट्स नियर टू द एपीआर दिस आइकन स्निफर आइकन go to the plus sign which is for it is a scanner which is scan all the IP in the, a particular network range all test ARP test whatever means broadcast and multicast the packets and receive the reply from all the IPs and it is noted down here in the tool so I just go okay So it scan all the IPs. So these are the IPs which is actually in the live mode. So 159, 254, 177. So if you just want to check first of all what is the IP of our attacker and then check the IP of the victim. I just go there IP config. So this is the default gateway. So there is a gateway 188.2 which is a gateway which is actually responsible to route our packet at the exit. Then there is a IPv4 address 211. It is the IP of the victim. Now just check the IP of the ifconfig. So there is IP 177, which is the another victim. This is the victim IP. We just noted down I 188 177. Then I just want to check the IP of the Windows 10 machine. This is also a victim machine. Just go there IP config. So it is having 159 168 159. Then fine, then I just go to the my victim machine. So after having all the IPs with me, then there is a in below there is a APR which is there is a. So I just click onto the APR. I just remove this, remove. Click on there, plus. So I just set the what is the target IP and the gateway default gateway. So I just check. This is the IP. Okay, this is a target one, which is actually we are doing the ARP DNS poisoning on that particular target. Okay, and then select the target default gateway. Likewise, again, I'm just go there and then select the IP of Windows 10 188.159. And then select the default gateway. I just want to check what is the gateway. Gateway is 188.2. So select in the target 2. I again show you what I did. I just go to the APR. I just click onto the APR, click on that particular empty space, go to the means click onto the plus, and then select the target one. When you select the target one, then it is automatically, there is another list which is the target two. Then you just select the default gateway. Okay, then both are the idle. Then go to the another in this particular tab, which is the APR DNS. Okay, and you just go there plus DNS name requested. So if someone trying to access from the victim machine certifiedhacker.com, so where it will redirect, you just write, you just click on to the, first of all, you just click this particular address is what you type in the victim browser, certifiedhacker.com, through DNS poisoning, where it will be redirect. So we just click on to the resolve and write www.google.com. Got it? And there is a IP, google.com, 172.217.167.228. Okay. I write okay. Then what is the next step? I just go there, Windows 7. Again, APR DNS. APR, sorry. I just so I just clicking onto the this APR, start stop APR. So this is ARP poisoning starting. Then I just go there, Windows 10, just write www.certifiedhacker.com. Chrome. www.certifiedhacker.com. I just go to the advanced, add exception, and from security exception. Let's just to the Google. See, because why it is not loaded over here? Because there is a, because I'm doing some practical, there is a IP 21658. It's a resolve the IP. I'm just putting that IP. I'm just putting that IP.
just save this. Just go there, DNS, get to list, www.google.com, resolve with hackthissite.org. Okay, it is resolved. Okay, fine. Okay. Again, we just start, stop, start sniffing. Go there. It takes some time. So, what actually the purpose of that means? This is poison, and when we starting this. This DNS, if I'm typing google.com, it must be forwarded to the the malicious ID. So I just try it here also. Connection is not private, advanced. Just reload. Sometimes the certificates are not installed, that is why, but it is working. It's poisoning, that is why the Google is not loaded properly. It is moving to the it is forward to the hackthissite.org. To the hackthissite.org. So it is actually because of the the certificates are not installed properly. It is asking for the certificate. If it is asking for the certificate, then it is fairly easy to forward to the. This is actually the exercise which we have done a lot of time. So you just go there and do the APR things. Then this APR, this is the poisoning, right? Like as I'm showing you that this is the poisoning. So it is redirect to the particular website. Means what I did. Then this ARP DNS, this is the google.com. Normally what the server does, they are doing the google.com, they are resolving the name of the google.com, resolve the name with the corresponding IP address. So we just spoof that IP. I'm just writing here the IP 137.74.187.104, which is the IP of the hackthissite.org. And because of the certificates are not installed, but it is working, then it actually redirects to the google.com IP. It's right to the google.com IP. So, secure connection cons. See, this is the certificate is only valid for the following names, hackthissite.org. So there are some issue with the machine that they are not properly installed the certificate, but it is redirect to our request to the hackthissite.org. This is the google.com is the invalid security certification. Sometime it is blocked, sometime it is working. So this is the whole sole purpose of that exercise, that you redirect. See, in this particular, that the certificate is only valid for hackthissite.org. So if I want to install the certificate, I'm trying. So it is not properly installed. Sometime it is installed, sometime not. So just write google.com. So in advance, this is the error code. If sometimes it is installed there, then it is easy to access that particular website. So this is the purpose of the exercise, is that we poison the DNS. If we are having the access of the DNS files, or if we are in the same network, we just snitch the system, we poison that particular DNS machine. So what the tool does, then whatever the, it actually sniff the traffic, which is between the this particular IP address or this particular gateway. They sniff the traffic, they are sitting in the same network. After the sniffing, they poison that ARP, their ARP request. If someone is trying to access the google.com, they are actually redirect to the attacker website. So it is does because the properly on a proper setup of the certificate, this is not reload that particular website, but it's working properly sometimes in the machines. So this is what the whole sole purpose of this exercise, to poison the DNS. So how we countermeasure the DNS? The countermeasure of the DNS DNS is we actually safe and secure the DNS. It is only accessed or editable by the admin user. And second thing, we just bind our ARP tables with the DHCP. So if someone tries to spoof the IP and or someone tries to spoof the MAC, then it is quickly addressable by the DHCP. It is quickly matched by the DHCP tables. Through DHCP tables, what the DHCP does, that it match the IP and the corresponding MAC addresses and the ARP, and gives the ARP up, because ARP is not having any checking mechanism of the IP and corresponding IP addresses. If someone spoofed the IP or the MAC address, it is easily passed through the ARP protocols, ARP tables. So we bind the ARP with the DHCP, and we just give the solution that the ARP or the DNS files is only accessible by the admin privileged person, and only editable by the admin person. So this is what the exercise is. I think I'm running out the time, and that's it from my side. Any query?
Nothing, sir. Thank you very much. Any queries? I request all the participants, if anyone have any queries related to this topic which has sir explained. No, sir, they don't have any queries. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all. Bye.